Well, we're coming out here now. This is Axman's Bridge, at least the trail leading to it. This is a spot that we marked as more urban legend than anything, but we're playing out the truth. Today, we're going to go over to the bridge itself and we're take a look at some. We were out here a few nights ago and we got some interesting stuff. For a bit of a legend, it was pretty eerie. We took a picture and we got a fog which looks like a woman. Fog is real interesting, and I'll show it a little bit later. The story behind Axman's Bridge is back there in the woods, a gentleman had dismembered a couple of bodies, two females, and the rumor is they walked through these woods. Also, it's become a very well-known satanic ritual ground. Satanists come out here and perform their rituals and ceremonies right at this very bridge. So we're going to take a look at that, and we're going to stay out here until morning. Welcome to Midwest Hunts.
And I'm recording. This is what we found. Jason, could you get up in there?
Yeah, let me get my picture. We're here at Axman's Bridge. What we did was we came back to this ritual spot that Jacob Ghostner had known about. And what it looks like we found is pit full of debris. Full of beer bottles, burnt sticks, and we got appears to be makeshift poultry. Jacob had told me before that Satanists have come out here and use this place.
Yeah, this is where the old house used to be.
This used to be a house here?
Yeah.
And this trail that we just came down is pretty well worn. It still goes deeper into the woods if you haven't noticed. Myself, I'm not sure, but my Jacob the cameraman's a very respected pagan. We don't like Satanists. So,
Very nice.
And next time, they'll pick a different set of words. I'm Jason Sullivan.
Can't really show how. Yeah, let's see if we can look. How used this path is. It's this path just leading off into nowhere up to that altar has been used a lot. And there's nothing but mud in all sides of its really thick vegetation. And we're getting ready to come back out on to the path where Axman's is, the actual bridge. Jason Sullivan is off gallivanting through the woods. Yeah. Well, I'll keep going just in case.
Alright.
You need to jump here?
Okay.
What is that back there? Something blue. Something blue over here. Like a banner, it looks like. It looks like a banner. Yeah, something big and blue. Can you see it right there? There's what? What about? There's some stone structure, it looks like here. Looks like a pillar almost. You see what I'm talking about? I'm trying to go back there. There's gotta be something. It's over there. I'm almost there. Yeah, it's right. tripod right here. Yep, yeah, I'm tripped over it.
Hang on, hold on. You
got
the camera?
Yep. I'm rolling that down. Can't need light on it. That's good, isn't it?
Yes, my friend, it is.
Barbed wire. Someone trying to trip someone out here.
Look fucking at this. Get that camera on me. See?
Yep, I got it on you.
Look at this. I think they're real cute. It's a barbed wire trap. Look at this. My cameraman, Josh Cameron, over here, just got a strip door here. Goes all the way across. That's still one for Midwest horse. We're out here at Axman's Bridge. We've been checking the place out. Nothing that unusual except for that little cult ground which I desecrated. Thermal reads for this area seem to be close to just about normal. 60 degrees, 55 degrees. I'm on an EMF scan. Now, the rumors of the place, it's kind of a little unsure because, you know, we've got about a half a dozen stories of what really you see out here. Story number one, there's a woman or something that crosses the bridge. Story number two is that you see the woman in the woods.
Later that evening, we took some shots at the bridge, shots at the framework, shots at the base. We did EMF readings and thermal meetings, we got nothing. Then I took a real good photo. I was taking a photo of my crew when this fog passed in front of me. As I look more and more at the fog in the picture, I can see the woman. The outline of her head, her shoulders, down to her neck and breast. It's clear. I took the shot again, the second photo right after that, and the fog was gone. I have no explanation.